begin in Dallas, where there are new worries tonight.
On our broadcast tonight, Ebola death in this country.
Breaking news, a major scare in New York City tonight with a possible case of Ebola.
PolitiFact is out with its lie of the year, and the award goes to hyped up claims about Ebola. Quote, fear of the disease stretched to every corner of America this fall, stoked by exaggerated claims from politicians and pundits. And looking back, the volume and the tone of the Ebola coverage over what now we know were a handful of cases in the United States did seem out of control.
I think it depends on how you look at it. The way I look at it, infectious disease experts I consulted were and remain very concerned about this because if it gets out of control in this country, we will not even be able to obviously deal with it.
So we shouldn't just be talking about it in the past tense.
I agree. And a lot of the media coverage has gone from overtime to almost nothing since they appointed the Ebola czar. And I don't think that's any accident. I think that's a strategy. But there is still cause for concern among infectious disease specialists. And I would argue, I think there's a good argument to be made, that things were made safer. The reason we don't have a worst case scenario today, as far as we know, is because there was media coverage, a public outcry that totally changed the way the government was handling the Ebola crisis and made it safer by instituting new rules at airports, by setting up SWAT teams so what happened, the horrible thing that happened to healthcare workers, hopefully would not happen again. That's a result, I believe, of the media attention.
Well, with the exception of the New York Times, which has aggressively covered the spread of this disease in Africa, you are right. I mean, it went from a million to zero. And I think it's not so much that Ron Klain was appointed the White House Ebola czar and he's now wrapping up his tenure doing that. It ceased to be a story for those of us here when Americans were no longer involved or at least infected. And that troubles me.
I think there's some credence to what you say, but I also think just having the experience and looking at how media coverage is steered, I would say once the Ebola czar came in, they quit putting out the head of the CDC, no more interviews. They quit
putting out. Tom Friedman used to be on every channel every day.
Someone decided, I think.
Yeah.
When we give information, they cover it. If we don't give information, it will fall off the stage, and it largely did. I called CDC not long ago and said, how many active cases are being monitored in the United States of Ebola? And they said 1,400. I said, where is that on your website, these updates? They said, we're not putting it on the web. So I think there is an effort to control the message and to tamp it down. This is public information we have a right to, and I think the media should not hype it, but cover it.
Well, you may be right in the sense that the president does help shape the agenda, and if he were talking about it or top officials were being made available, then we would all be talking about it. But I also think if it was still any nurses who potentially had it and who were fighting with their governors over the quarantine rules, we wouldn't be able to resist that story.
Yes, if there are more outbreaks, I think we will see more of what we had a couple of weeks ago. And again, there is good and bad to the idea of putting all that attention out there.
Well, based on what you told me, I think we can all agree on one thing, which is the story is not over, and we in the media need to recognize that. Thanks, Cheryl.